as a senior software engineer in the mobile department, especially for Android. And today I will present like a short introduction into the accessibility features in the Android Compose. So yeah, let's start. So the accessibility in app development ensures that all users, including those with the disabilities, can interact with and benefit from the application. This encompasses a wide range of disabilities, like visually, auditory, motor, and cognitive. For example, like blindness or low vision, deafness, hard of hearing, some difficulties during the using the touch screens, and other stuff. So designing with accessibility in mind often aligns with the universal design principles, making products more usable for all users. It is important. For instance, larger touch areas benefits users with motor impairments and those using devices in a challenging condition, for example, while walking. So accessible apps are easier to use, leading to higher user satisfaction and retention. This can directly impact an app. This can impact the success in terms of downloads, about the ratings, and when we are talking about the user engagement. Accessible apps, as I know, tend to rank better in the app stores due to positive user feedbacks and the higher engagement metrics. Besides, we have different standards in about that describing the accessibilities. So besides the ADA, like American with Disability Act in the USA, there are others international standards like WCAG, Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, and other specific to various countries. And understanding these standards is crucial for global compliance. Non-compliance with accessibility laws can lead to lawsuit, fines, and even reputational damage. It's not just about the legal risk, but also about protecting brand integrity and demonstrating a commitment to all users. Making app accessible aligns with broader CSR goals. It shows that the company values inclusively and it's dedicated to serving all user groups, which can enhance brand loyalty and the customer trust. We have a statistics that beyond the 15% of the global population has disabilities. We need to consider that this figure doesn't include the temporary disabilities. For example, when there is a broken arm or situations like when you are on a bright sideline, sunlight, when you cannot see your screen. So the number of users who benefit from accessibility feature is much larger. So it helps not only for the user for the users with disabilities, but even just in a using your application in some unusual situations. So about the Jetpack Compose. Jetpack Compose is the modern toolkit for building a UI for Android. It simplifies the development, especially about I mean the UI development, with less boilerplate code, and it is very powerful and intuitive Kotlin APIs. So Compose allows developers to describe the UI states and the structure in more declarative way, meaning that you describe what the UI should look like and how to construct. This reduces the complexity of state management. This reduces complexity of state management and makes the UI more predictable and easier to maintain. With in Compose we have like features like hot reload. Developers can see changes instantly without needing to recompile the entire application. This significantly increase and speed up the development and testing. Compose is designed to work seamlessly with other Jetpack libraries, such as old-fashioned live data, view model, and navigation. This synergy reduces the boilerplate code and improves the integration of modern app architectures, like MVVM, for example. Compose inherently supports many accessibility features, reducing the overhead of manually setting properties. For example, components like a text, button, and image are already equipped with the necessary attributes to support accessibility tools. We have the powerful modifier system in Compose, which allows developer to easily extend the functionality of components, including different accessibility properties with less code and fewer errors. By default, Compose widgets like a button, text, and image are accessible, meaning they interact correctly with it, for example, TalkBack. This includes announcing the role, states, and actions, which minimizes the developer's need to write additional code to describe everything. Compose provides more granular control over how elements are announced and described to the users, improving the quality of feedback that users get from this from screen readers. Providing meaningful descriptions for images, icons, and other especially non-text elements ensures that users with visual impairments understand the context and functionality of these elements. Developers can dynamically update content descriptions based on state changes, providing real-time feedback to the users, relying on the screen readers. I will show some code example of that in further slides. Also about the semantics that we have. Custom semantics allow developers to go beyond the default accessibility features and provide additional context of or modify existing context to better suit their application's need. Custom semantics useful for custom UI for custom UI components or when we are combining multiple components into a single interacting elements. For example, custom slider with some additional labels or controls. In this example, this is the very like a simple example what we can do. For example, we have here a button which has a text inside. So if we do not make additional content description here, the talkback will describe this element as a submit. But if we want to add more clarity, we can override the default predefined accessibility work. And we adding the content description. For example, in our case, it is submit button, and this will be announced to the user. There are situations where default actions do not provide enough granularity or specificity. For example, complex widgets like a custom slider, charts, or multi-step forms may require bespoke actions to communicate effectively with assistive technologies. So Custom actions can significantly improve user interactions by providing context-specific options and feedback. For example, when the user decrease or increase when the user want to decrease or increase when the user are using a slider. So it can add us and it can provide more control over the widget. We using a custom accessibility action for that purposes. This class allow the developer to define new actions that screen readers or other accessibility tools can trigger. This is particularly useful for custom components that require non-standard interactions. So here we have a slider where by using the semantics, we adding a custom accessibility action. As you see here, we have an increase and decrease action. So when user will interact with this slider and will perform the increase action, it will automatically increase the slider value by one or whatever we put here, and the same for decrease action. Also, it is important to test the accessibility. For that purposes, we have the accessibility scanner that automates the detection of common accessibility issues, such as missing content descriptions, small touch areas, or low contrast text. We also can integrate the accessibility scanner in our CI pipeline to automatically check the accessibility issues in every build, ensuring ongoing compliance and quality. So I mentioned about the low contrast text. I have a real life example that I faced in my life that once at my previous job, I had to take a test. And at the end of the test, there is a result of the answers is provided. The results were highlighted and the correct answers was highlighted in green and wrong answers in red. But there was one moment that I couldn't understand why I didn't get 10 of 10 if nothing was highlighted in red. But then only with the help of colleague, I realized that there was a lot of highlighted in the red. Why that happens? There was the wrong highlighting thickness of the area of the incorrect answer and very low contrast color. And of course, due to the fact that I cannot always distinguish the red color, I have some like color blindness, I was not able to see where are incorrect answers. So I was looking to the page and all answers was highlighted in brown and I didn't see what was wrong. So this is like a simple example about the importance of the accessible approach. So even the low contrast colors could destroy whole process of even the testing that I have. Okay, let's move further. Also, besides the testing tools, we have we need to write tests. So we using compose test rule to write tests specifically for compose UI. We can simulate user interactions and verifying that accessibility feature work correctly. Automated tests can check that UI elements have the correct content descriptions, are properly that they are properly focusable, and the custom actions are appropriately triggered. So this is simply a test that we can write. This test just checking if there is an element with provided content description. So here you can see that we are using compose test rule. We are looking the element with content description submit button, and we are checking if this element exists. This is the simplest test, but there is a lot of possibility we can perform the clicks and other stuff. For applications with dynamic content, like as I mentioned, chats, live feeds, or dashboards, it is important to notify screen readers of changes in real time. Using announcements or similar methods ensures that users are aware of content changes. This is crucial for error messages, some success notifications, or any real time updates. Old-fashioned way, we was using the accessibility manager by which we can trigger manually the actions. In our case, by clicking the button, we are sending the event that message is update, and user will hear the announcement of updated message. In the latest Google recommendations, they are recommending us to use the live region. It much simplifies this work, so we do not need to do it manually, but it relates on the states, and when the states is updating, it automatically understands that that application need to announce updates on the screen. The focus management in accessibility is not less important than other stuff. We need to ensuring a logical and intuitive focus is crucial for users when they are navigating with keyboards or other assistive devices. So you know that we can attach the keyboards or other devices to Android device, and that would help the user with some accessibility to navigate through your app. So the focus should move in the way that makes sense for the user interaction pattern. So for that purposes, we are using Focus Requester to manage focus programmatically, enabling or disabling focus on components as needed, based only on the user actions. So there is example, a simple example of a column with three elements, but here at the top of we creating references for first, second, and third element, and in that area that we have a focus order, we can tell from which to which element the focus should be moved. So when the user on the first element and he click, for example, arrow down, we ensuring that the next element after this will be the second element. When we are on the second element, we ensuring that we provide the next element in the our column, and also we provide the previous focusable element to which user will navigate by using left or right arrows or top or down arrows. When we building custom composables, it is crucial to use semantics properties to provide the necessary information to screen readers and other assistive technologies. For complex components with multiple children, we can use some merging semantics or overriding default properties. This can help to provide a better user experience. For example, here we have a row with only two elements, two text elements. Without the overriding the content description, TalkBack will announce element by element. For example, if we have 10 elements about some user information, The talkback will announce it in a raw way. For example, like talkback will announce the name, the number of age, and other information, but we can override it by providing the more understandable description on what happens on the screen. For example, we can add the description that the username is John, his age is 30, and other stuff. So we can improve the quality of what user receives from the application. To summarize the presentation that you see here, I can tell that accessibility is not just a feature. It's a core part of designing a user-friendly and inclusive application. Jetpack Compose simplifies the integration of the accessibility feature, but requires thoughtful implementation to be truly effective. The main points that I have that I was describing in this presentation, I can highlight these five points. That the first one is the we always need to provide meaningful content descriptions for non-text elements. The second one is the we need to regularly test our app with the real users who have disabilities or use screen readers and other assistive tools. The third one point is that we need to design with a range of disabilities in mind, including all disabilities like visual, auditory, motor, and cognitive. The next one is we need to use tools like accessibility scanner and incorporate libraries or different plugins that support accessibility best practice to be sure that we cover all accessibility cases. And the last one is that accessibility, we need to remember that accessibility is an ongoing effort. Ensure that we need to be sure that our app stays accessible as it evolves by continuously integrating when we are receiving the feedback from the users, when we are updating our features. We need to consider that and be sure that every detail in our application is accessible. I think that's it. For those who will be able to download this presentation, you can find the links that I was using to prepare this presentation. Mostly all of them are official documentation, like about the Compose, about the accessibility scanner, and official documentation about the accessibility at all. Thank you for your attention.